Lynn, Elma, I know you don't like me being friends with murderers, but that doesn't mean you have to turn your backs on me. Come on, I thought we were friends. Hey, everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X. In the last episode, Side Quest Fest continued. This time, I think we're going to go ahead and rock out Chapter 9. Rock out Chapter 9? Knock out Chapter 9. Rock and knock it. Elma and Lynn are required. I went ahead and used Murderous as my fourth character because she may not be high enough level yet, but she can use a skill, and I figure we need to work on somebody besides Hope, and we can't use Doug or Lau. I was thinking about using Doug, but we can't use Doug, so never mind. Let's do this. Got to get my other characters leveled up somehow, and if she ends up being useless, I'll just take her out of the party and put in Hope or Yelv or one of those other guys who's leveled up all the way. Are we going to get to cook this time without interruption?
What should I whip up today?
Something delicious, baby. Oh, it looks like since last time we got interrupted, we didn't actually get to finish cooking. So it wouldn't have mattered what I chose. It would have got interrupted. All right, so in that case, something braised, baby. Something braised.
That is a great idea.
Let's get back to what we were trying to cook last time before we were so rudely interrupted by the shit-take ganglions. Bath salts? There's some kind of salt in there.
This is not bathtub. This is pot of boiling wine.
Little Spud's smarter than he looks.
Almost had him that time.
Regular old beef instead.
Lily is not funny.
Just regular beef? I don't think I want regular beef. I'm sorry. Whoa.
Everyone, let's eat.
Doesn't look too bad, though. Not gonna lie. Doesn't look quite as good as the beef I just cooked up in my crock pot today. Which was delicious, by the way. But it looks alright. I ate it all, apparently, so it doesn't matter.
Now that hit the spot.
Sure done did.
Glad you enjoyed it, sir. I figured someone might show up unannounced, so I made a little extra this
unannounced?
Time.
He's here every time.
Then I'll just show up for random meals as I please.
That's not what I meant.
Oh, but it is what he meant. Anyway, so what's the mission today, Captain?
Okay. Good news first. Pathfinders detected another piece of the light.
Awesome.
Yes. Is it the core?
We don't know yet.
Tatsu do dance of discovery.
It's the same as every other dance you do, sir.
That's why we need you to check it out ASAP. The coordinates we have for it are up north of New LA, in Silvalum.
One sec. Silvalum? Correct me if I'm wrong, but, didn't we just detect signs of a ganglion presence there?
That's the bad news. Which is why I'm only asking our top combat units to take this on.
That would be me.
Understood. Consider it done, Commander. We'll get started immediately.
Consider it done.
I talked to Lau's team as well, by the way. They're already en route. You'll rendezvous with them here. Good luck.
Gotta meet up with Lau, alright. Gotta meet up with the Laosians. Alright, rendezvous with Lau to begin. Then let's do it. Oh no, we're down to... Is that 14%?
There's not much time left.
Dude, we must have to... We must be finding the life hold soon. Clearly finding the life hold isn't the end of the game, because that percent is way too low for that to be the case. Alright, let's get it popping, guys. To Silvalum! Like we haven't been there enough already. Not complaining, I love Silvalum. I'll go there any day, any time, any second, any day, any minute of the day, second week, month. Is that clear enough for you? Mm-hmm. I was going to talk about what I did between episodes, but I really didn't do anything. I actually haven't played this game in like, I want to say like 5 or 6 days. Whenever I recorded my last session, I recorded like 3 episodes in a row. I did that big chapter 8 battle bullshit that happened. The ganglions tried to steal my shit, and then they stole my shit. We did that, and then also, I forgot to bring my goddamn scales. What is wrong with me? How am I going to forget my scales? Sorry, gotta go back. Actually, we can use something, right? Can't we use, like, return to scale? Yes, we can. Yes, baby, we can. But yeah, and then the last two episodes, which were both Quest Fest episodes, which is one long Quest Fest, which I split in half. That was all one recording session. I don't know if I really explicitly said that, but that was, I think actually a week ago, now that I think about it. I believe I recorded all that last Saturday, and today is Saturday, so that would certainly make the most sense. Wait. Lao's team's right here. Wait. Oh. Hold on. Lao doesn't look too good, or is he just chilling? Hard to tell the difference. Hey, what's up? Just chilling on this rock over here. He don't look too good, but maybe, like I said, he's just chilling.
You can't be serious. Your entire team gone?
Dead. Killed by Ganglion. And it's all my fault.
If only we'd gotten here sooner.
What? You think you could have stopped it?
Why didn't they kill you? That's what I'm wondering.
Just bring them all back once we find the life hold, right?
Hey, Lao.
Look at us. The chosen few. All those people we left on Earth. They never had a chance. But us, we can be reborn. We get as many damn chances as we want.
If we find the core. Without that, there's no chance for any of us. Look, we can talk later. For now, we need to get you back to the city. Let's regroup there so we can get you patched up.
No way. What if it turns out to be the core and the Ganglion get to it first? You can't let that happen.
We can't just leave you here, Lao.
You can and you will. I'll be fine until the Reclaimers can get here.
Still.
I'm sending you all the intel we have. It's further north from here. Sorry, I can't help. It's up to you now.
Don't worry. We can handle it. Let's get moving. With luck, we can secure the life hold before the Ganglion know we're here.
Well then, let's hope we get lucky.
Yeah?
Maybe you should sit this one out. The place is crawling with Ganglion.
That's why I'm going. Exactly why. I'm part of a team, and we have a job to do. If it's going to be dangerous, that's all the more reason for us to stick together. And I'm a lot more capable than you think, Lao. But I know you're trying to look out for me, and I appreciate it.
It's not like they'll be killed. They'll just lose their mims is all. What's it matter anyway?
So, there is something to that, huh? Too bad it doesn't even matter because I'm so badass. It doesn't matter what keep wanting to call Lao Lin. Whatever Lao thinks is going to happen to us, I'm too badass to let it actually happen. Why I'm going to fight these Oxervs? I don't know. Just feel like it. Hopefully they don't destroy Murderess's thing. But because I have Lin and Elma, we should be fine. What was I going to say? Oh, I was going to say the whole situation where the alien scale got stolen. We have reason to believe that Lao may have let that happen. Accidentally or on purpose, I don't know, but he definitely seemed to be responsible for letting that happen, and Elma has her suspicions. We saw that, and I feel like it's coming to fruition now, and based on whatever happens in this next few moments when we attack this Ganglion base that we're about to attack, then we'll find it. Well, I'm saying a Ganglion base, but I actually don't know that for a fact. I don't even know why. I'm expecting the Ganglion to be all up on this life hold piece, just like the last few that we found. I'm also expecting it to get destroyed immediately, like the last couple we found as well. Is it really going to be the life hold? Like, the, is it really going to be the core? Sorry, we're looking for the core. Of course it's the life hold. to all the Lifehold. Is it going to be the core, is the question. That remains to be seen. Will it be the core? The core in question. Oh god, crocodiles everywhere. Run, bitch, run! Run from the crocodilius! Oh shit! Oh, they destroyed Murderess's fucking skull. God damn it. Where am I going, anyways? I'm actually going to... Whoa! I'm looking at my map for a second, and I've... Oh, god damn it. Alright, let's... Wait, what? There's a... Hold on, there's a quest over here. Wait a tech. Alright, well... How come I haven't been over here yet? This is literally just on the other side of the ocean area. The water area that I was all over earlier. Anyway, Dirk, what's up with the quest, bro? Can't have a quest out in the middle of nowhere and shit. Anyways, I might go back and get Murderess's scale going, but we'll see. Say, you're Funky G, right? Nice. My name's Dirk, and I'm out here on assignment for the Harriers. I was just talking with the guys back at the base about the crazy new rookie working with Elma. I was hoping we'd get a chance to talk someday. You guys have been cutting through the ganglion like a hot knife through butter. What's the secret? You cook up genius plans before heading into battle or what? You're damn right. That's exactly what we do. We are clever as shit. I'd love to hear your story sometimes. I'm a sniper myself, so sneaky is pretty much my whole game. Hey, so you're free right now? Like right now? Me and the rest of the team Jaeger are supposed to hunt down critters in Savalon for materials. If you aren't doing anything else, maybe you'd like to come along. I just really want you to watch you work. Would that be okay? I guess so. I mean, we'll take the mission. Probably not going to do it right now, though. We're in the middle of a main mission, bro. Ah, nice! I'll be honest. This is my first time here, and I was feeling pretty nervous until now. You don't mind, do you, Adalbert? What, like Adalbert Steiner from Final Fantasy IX? The list of the materials we're after is pretty long this time. Fine by me. I'll take any help I can get. The area is teeming with the Indrus Indrigens, and they're ganglion forces around to boot. Frankly, I was worried about getting my work done while having to babysit the rookie. Hey, I've seen a few battles. I'll show them. This hunt is my chance to prove Fina and Gret how far I've come. Who are Fina and Gret? I have no idea. Sure. You got this. Thanks. I'm sure I will bag a big one. Yeah, you bag it. I look forward to that. Wait, I look forward to that when and if it happens, Rook. Now let's get this hunt started. Okay, the two other girls right there must be Fina and Gret, yeah. Fina, Gret, I need a favor. We'll start the hunt here, but I need you to head to the base and gather information on the materials we're looking for. You think you give me orders and boring orders, no less? Whoa, easy. Backup's still an important role. And besides, there's half an ice cream cake left in the freezer. We can eat it when we go back. Ice cream cake? Yeah, alright, I'm sold. But you owe Fina for this one, Adalbert. I'll keep that in mind. Alright, let's secure the area. Hunt down any Entera monocerosis. Entera monocerosis. I don't even know what those are. How about a little race, Funky G? If I heard about it, you have no trouble beating me. Sure. Tell Albert to take his work more seriously? Of course I accept your challenge, sir. Challenge accepted. Ha, I like your style. Alright, I'm ready to do some damage. Let the games begin. Stay on your toes, everyone. We're the only humans out here, and I don't want any accidents. Well, you just go ahead and stay on your toes, bro. I'm busy. I got shit to do that doesn't involve bothering with you. That's for damn show. Anyway, I'm literally not even gonna bother with this round. Are you? Oh, those are the intramonitocerosis. Sorry, I'm like, which one is my skill again? Dur. Dur. Alright. We'll deal with those later. Also, get away from me, Falsaxum. Whoa, I'm stuck. I don't want to be here. I'm trying to go this way. There we go. Wait, why am I going this way? This is not... Okay. Alright, now I'm just lost. Trying to find a good way to go. I guess we're going. Okay, I got spun around. Whoa, what? I don't like the music. Usually, when that music starts, something. Yeah, a boss monster tries to fight us. I don't know what kind of boss monster it was, but I was outie. Shivering Sands. How have I not been over here, man? Oh my god. Hold on, we're here. Wherever here is, we're here. I guess I just haven't gone over here on the map, and I was waiting to go over here when I was on screen, I guess. I didn't expect the story to take me over here, though.
Is this the spot? That's weird.
I don't see any life holds around here. Yep. Lao, you motherfucker. Oh, Lao. You will regret this decision, Lao.
Go ahead and double-check the coordinates, would you?
Right.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Indeed, as do I.
Elma! I'm picking up multiple incoming heat signatures. We're surrounded!
Bring the heat, bitch! You think you can handle moi? Bring it. I got scales for a reason, bitch. Bring it. Lao will have to answer for this bullshit. Oh god, it's these peoples. It's Lion-O. And Chitara. I know that's not even close, but whatever. It's almost like Red 13 standing up on two legs. Even more badass. Human?
I haven't seen this species before.
Look at your kitty! Here, kitty!
Shut up! We're here!
Your first time laying eyes on the proud people of Roth?
Roth.
Surrender, humans. We have you surrounded.
If I had my scales, you'd be
if
done.
You put away your weapons and comply. You will be treated with the respect that warriors of your caliber.
As they say, everyone, we don't have a choice.
Lame.
Luxar's conniving has served them to us on a platter, which only makes the task all the less palatable.
This guy is not a fan of the plans, which is good. It's bodes well for me, because he might, well, you know, switch sides and hang out with me. Who knows? He looks pretty cool. I'd take him on my team in a heartbeat. It's like a half Ganondorf, half Red 13, half fucking Lion-O Thundercat. I'll take him, man. He's badass.
Don't worry. I'm in charge here. My subordinates are of no use.
God, the lyrics are ruining this.
I ask that you let them go.
Unfortunately, that is not my decision to make. We are mercenaries. We do as our patron. Deliver all of them to the Ganglion stronghold.
I thought the Ganglion wanted all humans eradicated. Why take us captive?
An excellent question. The Ganglion are indeed terrified of your species. However, this fear is only of your natural form.
Our real bodies? But why? Why would they fear our real bodies?
This I do not know. If I did, I would gladly lay their wretched plans bare.
Prince Jarg?
Luxar never ordered us to keep his secrets, only to remember his precious title. Take them away.
Luxar? Is that the Ganglion leader? Wait. First, I have a question. How has a noble species such as yours allowed itself to be reduced to such disgrace?
What?
The Ganglion have committed unspeakable acts all across this planet. Surely you must know that. They kill without cause or mercy. Why would you serve such scoundrels? Why sink so low?
Mind your tone, human. Who are you to judge the prince's actions? What could you possibly know of our people's struggle? Of how our homeland was torn away from us?
It's true. I cannot say I understand your plight. But humanity lost its home, just like you. And yet we chose to stand up and fight the Ganglion.
The Ganglion have bought our compliance, yes. But make no mistake, the Rothians would never sell their pride.
Prove it, then. Make a choice here that you can be proud of.
The ganglion would have us dismiss you as uncultured savages. But I see reason in your words and strength in your bearing. Very well. We will settle this the old way. Defeat us in battle. And yes, you will also win your freedom.
Elma always talking her way out of shit? I'm a fan. Except... Challenge accept. I'm accepting challenges like left and right today. Excellent.
I will grant no quarter and expect none in return. Mercy would be an insult.
But my prince, win or lose, Luxor will punish us.
Forgive me. I can suffer those villains' unjust orders no longer.
Of course, we all feel the same. But when the ganglion hear of this...
Roth will survive. Ours is a resilient people. We can weather this storm.
Yes, my prince. With you leading us, yes.
Then it's settled. Let the battle begin. This is the Rothian way.
Well, I'm down with the Rothian way. You gotta love that Elma can talk her way out of shit. Oh shoot! Lightsaber battle time! Bring it, ho! Let's go to yo lightsaber. Or yo lightsaber, girl. You can have one too, don't even matter. Light spear, I guess you could call that. We got guns! Guns versus swords. Fuck, can we get... We do get to use our scales, right? Like, I was in the scale before this started. Do I get to use my scale? Yes, we can. I want to use it. Aw, shit, no, we can't. No, we are on foot. We are fighting. We are going to lose. Murderess cannot handle this better scale. Well, then. Whatever. Not a guarantee we'll lose, but it certainly does not help. In the case that I cannot use my scale, which is what this looks like, I will go pick somebody up. I might go grab Hope. In fact, I'm probably going to go grab Hope. Hope will give me hope that I can win. Because without Hope, murderer, I mean, without a character who can last, fucking, I... Yeah, the beginning of this battle was already fucked because I didn't help. There goes this battle. Man, this is going to be a tough one. I can see it already. Alright, well... In lieu of my death, that's impending doom. I was like, just kill me already, jeez. Okay, so where does that put me? If it puts me... I'm assuming it's going to put me right before that cutscene started. Indeed, it did. Okay. So I'm gonna go get Hope in my party, and I shall return. Wait. We wouldn't... Hold on. Can we use our scale? Let me try. Before I waste my time going back and then realize I could have used my scale. Because, like, I know it was outside the little area, but does that just mean... Is that just because? Let's find out. If it goes cutscene mode and we have to, like, start over, that's fine. Whatever. Let's just see what happens. Damn it, we have to fight on foot. Ah, son of a bitch. Okay. Well, it is what it is then. Alright, let's try this again. And you know what? I'm gonna attack this guy first. Or not. Well, whatever. As long as we're attacking the little helpers first, that's a good idea. Because these motherfucking warrior bitches are gonna go down a lot easier. Now that we have hope. Literally, we have hope. With hope comes great hope. That we could have a chance to win, although Lynn just got her ass handed to her. That's fun. But see, we took out one, and now it gives me the feeling that we could take out more, you know? That was a major ass burp. Also, Hope is dead already. Well then. Man, really. There's gotta be a good way to do this battle. I mean, I think I have the right idea, in that we should take out the other guys first. But why is Hope... Why they gotta jump the shit out of Lynn and fucking Hope so fast? That was, like, not even fair, man. Didn't even give me a chance, man. And this guy's just about dead, which is good. but by the time he's dead, I'm already gonna be fucked, you know?
That's a harvest you intend to struggle?
Ravian sneaker, huh?
And died better still.
This is gonna be frustrating. I can see it already. Man. Wait, what? No, don't lower the difficulty. That's for noobs. You don't do that. You don't even give me that offer game. How dare you? How dare you even suggest that I be a noob and I fucking make it easier? Don't you even make that suggestion, bitch ass. Anyway, let's try that again.
Do your worst.
Alright, here we go. Fucking rock this bitch. Rock him inside out. We're gonna rock this bitch, make him scream and shout. We're gonna rock this bitch. We're gonna rock. Fuck, Lynn is gonna die again, son of a bitch. I tried to rock it. Tried to rock it like Herbie Hancock. Didn't work out so well for me. Anyway, that's one dead. Hope lasted through one. I don't know, man. Do I really gotta level these bitches up more? Like, seriously? It's upsetting that 32 is not gonna be high enough. But I mean, don't get me wrong. This Jarg guy and his fucking girlfriend are level 34 and 33, so they are higher than, you know, half my party. And with six on four is a little bit uneven. They got the advantage when it comes to chipping away at my fucking health. I can't use my skills, so there goes that advantage. There's probably some abilities and shit I should be using that would make these fucking on-foot battles not as bad as I'm making them. This is lame. Alright, time to give it another go, bitch! Notice how all my characters are a little bit higher level. Well, I've learned the technique of power leveling. And I didn't look it up or anything, but I figured it would be nice to try it out because we got skells, right? So I was like, I've been avoiding these high level monsters even though we have skells. Like, of course you gotta stay away from the big ass monsters. Like, those will fuck your skells up. But what about small monsters who are high level? So what I did is I went and fought a couple monsters that were level 50. With my skills, and little did I know, all my characters went up levels immediately after fighting those monsters. Also, I probably didn't go into this with the best strategy. I just went in here willy-nilly, going straight after God Jarg over here. I probably should be attacking his little friends, but then again, I'm also keeping him occupied. So, I don't know. Is this the way to do it? I'm probably better off still going through one at a time like I was doing before. I don't know. Maybe I'm not high enough level still. Maybe I should go fight a few more of those level 50 monsters and get just even ever so slightly stronger. Because so far we haven't killed a damn thing. And Hope and Lynn went down first already. We don't even have Gajarg half dead. Like, I'm pretty sure we can handle him, but I think we gotta take out his little friends first. I think I'll give it one more go before I go do maybe a little bit more leveling. Just a little bit. Like, maybe get my characters all the 35 or 36, depending on how hard that is. But yeah, see, we're lasting pretty good against Gajarg by himself, so if we would have went one at a time, we might be able to take out more of them. Alright, let's try to do my strat of attacking one of these bitches at a time. Oh, here we go. Let's get one of these motherfuckers first. Damn it, I hella missed. Yeah, maybe one of these fuckers at a time is the way to go. Ignore Gajang or whatever. Gajarg. Even though that's probably still not advisable. Although if I keep them attacking me, we might be alright. Instead of having them attack my homies, you know? Kill them now! We almost got one dead before Hope's dead. That might be good. Come get me, bitches. Damn it, Hope died before I got one down. Anyway, there goes one. One down! We're not gonna be able to do this, man. I might have to level up another level or two. Oh, wait, we got another one dead already. That was quick. Get this guy, or girl. No, don't get her, never mind. Don't get her. Get this guy. Yeah, get him. Fuck this guy. There you go. Get that guy. I still had Elmo alive until just now. Oh, man. Did you see that fucking... I jacked that motherfucker up. My damage output is insane right now. It's too bad I'm all alone already. That sucks. And here I thought I was going to have a chance that time. But I am smart, see? We got him down to only the three... The two cat main people and then the third little friend they have here, which is this little sneaker bastard. Alright. Maybe I'll go do one more level or two. Alright, let's try this motherfucker one more time. Not that I'm only going to try it one more time, but like, let's give it another shot. Everybody's level 36 at least now. Man, it really is nice to have them scale power leveling skills, man. It really takes very little effort to level up if you want to only go like a level or two. I only really meant to go up one level, but I fought two monsters and everybody went up two levels again. So there you go. Can't take back. In fact, even I went up a level or two. What was I? Was I 38 last time I tried? I think so. Anyway, Lynn already died though, man. We may have to try this a few times before we actually get a victory. But I think we're strong enough now. I feel like we are. It seems to me we're strong enough. We gotta kill these other guys first, man. There you go. Get them. Get that enactor. Get them. Fuck them up. Go, Gajar are strengthening their teamwork. That's fine. Strengthen their teamwork. They're all going to be dead. I don't know why the game sees fit to give me tips when I'm clearly going to win. Duh. Maybe I really should just jump the main guys first. Whatever. I'm not going to go level up again. Let's just try go straight for the Jarg man this time. See if we can actually do something to him. Take him out. Look how long I last now, just because I'm level 39. Fuck him up. What? I didn't mean to attack him first, but whatever. Oh, the sneaker. Actually, this is probably a good one to take out first now that I think about it. If I take out the sneaker, that could be one less little bastard I gotta worry about. Well, duh, one less little bastard. It's called math. What I mean is the one of the more annoying bastards will be dealt with. Yes, attack me, please. Everyone go for me. Anyway, Lynn's dead, but you know what? Or no, she's not dead. Lynn is alive. I am doing okay. Don't you kill my Elma. Aw, there goes Lynn. You motherfucker. Eat my... Just eat it. Bitch ass. I meant to attack him first. Don't get me wrong. I was actually going to go for him, but then apparently by the way I like tried to lock on, I locked on the guy behind me instead. Which wasn't exactly what I was going for. Oh well, what are you gonna do? Stag a swagger. If we could kill Gajiarg, we might be able to win this, but instead we're gonna lose again. Man, this battle is not easy. I'm sure that there is something about the battle system that I am terrible at, and I'm sure I will get pointed out. This is going to be the first time this shit's getting exposed, like, badly. God, I keep missing that B press. Oh my god, again! I missed the B press 3 times, man. I'm still alive. This is ridiculous. My homies are not strong enough. Gonna get them. Alright, let's fuck him up. Fuck him up. Fuck him up real good. Girl power for the win. Eat a cat. Come get me, bitches. Come to Butthead. We don't even have him a third of the way dead, and my party members are all gonna die already. Lame. Whoa, we're doing good damage to him all of a sudden. I don't know what happened, but I'll take it. Now, if we can somehow take him out, I might even consider this an opportunity to win this. Maybe if we beat him, the match is automatically over. Wouldn't that be a hell of a thing? I doubt it, though, since it says achieve all objectives. Oh, that's as far as I've ever gotten him. Man. Shall I give it another go now, children? Let's do it. I didn't mean to start attacking her first, but maybe that'd be a good thing if I attacked her first. I don't know. Find out. Also, you'll see my level now is 37 with everybody or higher. I'm even level 40 now, which wasn't... It's not really how I wanted to be able to do this, but I was getting frustrated by this battle, and I just want to be done with it now. There will come a day that my lack of being able to understand and get good at this battle system will come to bite me in the ass. And that day might be today, because I still am not on pace to beat this battle. Not with the way this round is going. Man. I still maintain that I might be better off attacking the other ones, like the weaker ones first, because you can get rid of them much faster. And that ship damage doesn't exist. But if we can get rid of, like I said, if we can get rid of one of these bitches, we might have a good chance, but we're not going to get through one of them with anybody else alive, because everybody else will be dead, man. I'm going to survive long enough to kill her, probably. But then everybody else is going to be dead, because Elma's all I got left right now, and she's about to die. Maybe my armor just sucks. Maybe my weapons suck. Maybe I just suck at this game. What is the reason why I'm getting wrecked so hard at this? Is it really just because my strategy is that bad? Is that really all it comes to, chalk it up to just bad strategy? I mean, I'm sure that's part of it. Don't get me wrong, but like, should I be getting wrecked this hard? I'm getting wrecked like super, barely even. I'm not even gonna kill the one bitch because she doesn't. She refuses to die. Ah, man, this is a frustrating turn of events, man. It really, really is. Let's see if killing these guys really is a good way to do this. I actually killed one of them before I got killed. Wow. Actually a very good attempt that did not expect to turn into a good attempt. But you know what? We're doing pretty good, and we almost got Gajarg here dead. I'm actually feeling like we're going to win this one, barring some crazy raging attack by one of them. But at this point, even if one of my people go down, well, as I say it, there goes Lin. That's alright. Come on, Elma, we got this. Elma, we got this, girl. Oh, shit. I keep missing my B press, man. It's so fast. Alright, I think I got this battle, though. I am supposed to take out the scrubs first. If I can get rid of this Gajarg guy, I think we got this already, though, man. This fucker doesn't want to go down. Fucking go down, bitch. Stay down, bitch. Aw, man. Bitch had to hit me while I was trying to use my yellow move. Damn it. Bitch toppled me. We're gonna lose this time, but that's fine. That's fine. We'll be back and we're gonna do it again. Come on, baby. Okay, I killed him, but are we going to be able to live long enough to kill this bitch too? I don't know, man. It is 2-on-1, but she might go apeshit on us. We got to be careful. I can't believe we're gonna win this. This is a sad victory. I mean, I shouldn't say it's a sad victory. It's a happy victory. I'm glad I'm winning. But like, I wanted to win so much more emphatically than this, not just outlast this bitch because we're playing 2-on-1. I was really hoping to have my whole party alive for this, but whatever. Victory is upon us, children. Gabweed hay. About to be god dead hay, bitch ass. Should I revive somebody while we're at it? I'd rather save my TP, to be honest. Anyway, die, bitch. Done. Victory. Awesome. That was not easy. Even with my overleveled ass. Holy shit. My strategy was terrible. I'm sure you guys are already yelling at me. Like, super hard.
A fight worthy of Gunjar. Well met. But how will you fare when the sticks are raised?
Ah, shit. Wait, what? Not well.
Act 2 begins. Equip yourselves as you see fit.
Ah, fuck.
Let the real battle begin.
You mean that wasn't the real battle? That shit was impossible. Oh, man. Now we gotta go scale fight. Alright. Oh shit, his scale is way more badass than my scales. Look how armored that shit is. Holy fuck, man, I'm scared. Help me. Oh my god, I'm so fucked right now. Wait. Oh, the battle hasn't begun. Okay, equip yourselves as you see fit. Thank you. Thank you for giving me a chance to let my stuff heal and give me a chance to get my scale. You are nice. Now bring it, bitch. You come scared? I ain't scared. Bring it, bitch. I am a little scared, I'm not gonna lie. But knowing how well we can deal out damage as in scales, I'm less concerned. Because damage dealing is what we do, baby. It's what we do. It's what we do and how we do it every time we fucking do it. It's what we do. This is what we do. This is what we do. Do. This is how we do it according to MC Hammer, baby. Wow. For as much as I struggled with that first round, this is not even gonna fucking make me break a sweat. For real, though. If only because scale battles, while they are dangerous and you can lose your scale and whatnot, are a lot easier to manage, especially since you can deal out so much more amounts of damage if you... Well, of course, if your scale is that kind of scale. But of course, that's my kind of scale, man. Damage-dealing motherfucker. Anyway, this big armored motherfucker is about to go down eventually. Just a matter of time. Oh, shit. Unless he does that. What the fuck was that shit? I don't even know, man. Can we bind his ass? That'd be real sweet if we could bind him. I'd be down to bind him. Aw, shit. Every fucking time, I swear it never fails. Scratch my forehead right when it wants me to press B. Swear to Jesus. Oh, it had the bind. Oh, somebody's binding him. That's good. That's good. Somebody's binding him. Very good. Very good. This is the damage-dealing moment right now, children. Why do I keep guys calling you guys children these days? I don't know, man. Because you're all a bunch of fucking children! That's why! Grow up already! No, that's not it at all, guys. I'm not even doing the bind. The rest of my team is. I love having all scales. I love that we can just fucking have everyone bind. It's just, it's amazing to me. It's awesome. And amazing and badass. Overdrive. Is it overdrive time? The Vassar is veiled in a barrier of energy. Well, that's not good. What does that even mean? Does that mean we can't hurt him? Oh, he's invincible. Does that mean back the fuck off? Or I'm scared. I'm scared. Is he gonna become not invisible any minute time, time soon? Wait, he has friends? How come I didn't realize he had friends over here? I mean, I knew he had friends with him. That's not the surprise. The surprise is that they're actually doing something. I didn't realize they were actually trying to get up in this battle. You're trying to be a part of this? Bro, you can't just be a part of it. It's not how it works. Bro. It's not how it works. Get out of here. It looks like he's just still sitting over there invincible and shit, huh? Yeah, I'm assuming we gotta take out his little friends over here. Bro, dude, Beezies. Can I get y'all help over here? I can't be doing this all by myself. Can I make everybody come over here and fight? Come over here and fight, please. Ignore the fucking invincible bastard who won't even let you hurt him anyways. And come over here and help me deal some goddamn damage to these motherfucking shitty Kaladar bitches. He's just gonna sit there on his ass and watch it happen. I assume he'll stop being invincible once we finish taking out his little friends over here. And then we won't have to worry about being back attacked and shit, you know? So let's just... No, stay over here! Ah, over here, you dumbasses. Over here. Gotta get used to being able to make everybody concentrate their attacks. Alright, I think he finally... Yeah, he woke up. Okay, so we just had to take out his friends. And then he woke the fuck up. Alright, cool. He was just taking a nap for a while. You know him. Sitting over in the corner, taking a nap. Son of a bitch. See how it is? I did not mean to accidentally just do my overdrive. But you know what? Whatever. If ever there's a time to use it, it's in a boss fight. So go for it, bro. Go for broke. Go for broke. Is he invincible again? What's happening right now? No, he's not invincible again. I'm not sure why that little invincible word popped up. But I'll take it. To the bank, baby. To the victory. To the victory. Nobody lose your scale. Nobody lose your scale. Flawless scale victory, baby. Yeah, eat it. Eat it, Catman. But did we actually fight to the death? That's the real question.
I thank you for this defeat. Our encounter has been most edifying. North of here lies a shadowy land of rock and fire. Jagged black stone, lit only by scars of boiling magma. There, you will find the ganglion stronghold.
Found it already, I know. They're everywhere, man.
May the tides of war lift your fortunes!
So now what? We gotta go back and lynch Lao for fucking us over, or what? Or is he gonna fucking finally have inspired hope because we lived to tell the tale?
That guy was not so bad, huh?
Yeah, he said they're mercenaries. Maybe we could convince them to fight for us.
Great idea, Linley. Tatsu love kitties.
I wouldn't call them kitties to their face, small fry. They'd slice you up, grind the wedges, add a nice buttercream sauce, then...
Linley talking way too many details.
Oh, sorry. Was I saying that out loud?
Linley is not funny.
Hey, good news. Lao was just admitted to the maintenance center. Looks like he's gonna make it.
Really? Oh, thank God they got to him in time. Let's hurry back and check in on him.
Right.
Right. Check in on him or interrogate him?
What is it?
Nothing. about Lao. Let's get back to New LA.
In more ways than one. Worried about that Lao bastard. Alright, let's go finish this chapter off. I'm assuming just gotta go talk to Lao and then maybe the commander and we'll call that a day, huh? Eh? Meh, 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 meh. Whew! After all them cuts, I'm sure this episode's probably not even... Well, it might be reasonably long after we're finally done with this chapter. We'll see how much more cutscenes and stuff have to come up, because clearly, we're about to get some more ganglion stuff going down. Remember, this motherfucker was trying to wake up that skull. Did it work? It looks like it's moving.
Grandmaster Luxar.
I thought I told you never to disturb me in this chamber. What is it?
A message from Gajar. You'll want to see it, sir.
Counselor Luxar, this is mercenary warlord Gajarg, former prince of the Kingdom of Roth. It is with a heavy heart and deep regret that I must report to you that the Rothian people are unable to carry out your mission to annihilate the human race. We realize this means we will no longer enjoy the benevolence of ganglion patronage. So be it. The Rothian people will make our way as an independent mercenary force, effective immediately. We look forward to settling our debt with you on some future battlefield. Until then.
Gajarg, you traitor! I should have known those ungrateful rats would bite the hand that feeds them!
Quit talking to yourself, bro. You're not even saying any words. You're just mumbling to yourself. God, he looks disgusting. I like how he announced it. The Rothian race would gladly like to invite you to suck our collective dicks. Thank you, and good night. That would have been hilarious. Uh-oh. Forces are gathering. But whose forces? Are these the Rothians? Yes, yes they are.
You seem to enjoy that, Prince John.
But what a shame.
Now we're all gonna die.
What that overgrown slug calls a face.
My prince, what has gotten into you?
You disapprove?
On the contrary, everyone loves a scoundrel.
Is that so? Then we're in luck. From this day forth, we are lawless vagabonds, subject to no one.
Ha ha!
To
no one.
Rothian scoundrels!
They're like, hell yeah! I love living on the run. I want to be a gypsy. And then we get a nice long black screen. This is awesome. The blackest of screens. Oh god, that was a long ass black screen. I was worried for a second there. Like, there wasn't even a loading thing or nothing. I was like, that didn't look too good. Alright, anyway, we're done here. Let's head back to the admin district. To the admin district. We're going to the Mimeosome Maintenance Center to check on Laojin Bastard. That Laojin conniving bastard. He tried to get me killed. But I ain't gonna have it. Nope. Not even a little bit. Not even a little bit. He think he can screw me over? You crazy, man. Yes, there is a quest that's right over here. I decided I was going to wait to start it until I could do another quest fest, which is now on the horizon. Now that we are about to wrap up Chapter 9, we're going to do another quest fest. Festival of quests. Maybe we'll go around. Oh, wait, hold on. Let's just do cutscenes first, and we'll talk about other things afterwards. You going to be alright there, Lao? He's probably going to have a heart attack when he sees us. Oh, there's Doug. So this is the whole reason we couldn't use Doug. Because of this one cutscene.
Doug? Is this
You wish.
New LA, buddy. Sorry, no real body just yet. They saved your men before it shut down. Too bad, huh? Better luck next time you die.
See, Doug, it's all my fault.
Save it. Just rest. Take a look for yourself. Say hi.
Thanks.
Doug, we need to talk. Can you spare a minute?
Of course.
We need to tell you all about Lao's treacherous bullshit.
Suggested we go after it. He even planned the mission. So we extract it. And the Ganglion know exactly where it is when they come for it, with Lao's team away from guard duty.
Oh, boy.
And this last mission, he gave us coordinates for a lifehold unit he found. It turned out to be a Ganglion ambush. It's too much to be a coincidence, Doug.
Yeah, man.
What do you think, Rook? You think he's a spy?
Is spy the word we want to use? He's something. I don't know if we couldn't call it a spy.
He saved our bacon plenty of times. We should at least give him a chance to explain himself. We owe him that much.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
He didn't save my bacon. He didn't leave any bacon for me, man. I want some bacon. Anyway, are we going to get to this confession now, or is that it? I guess that's it, huh? Story mission completo. And that's it? Chapter 9 done, and we're done, and we're done, and we're done? No more cutscenes or nothing right now? Just long-ass, dark, black screen loading screens? Awesome. Okay, the scale flight. Whoa, 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 huh? Our flight-capable scale prototype is finally ready for... Yes! Oh. Oh. I can fly? No. I didn't... Oh, my God. We're going to be able to fly, guys. I honestly didn't think we're at... Dude, we're going to get to fly in the next episode of Xenoblade Chronicles X. We're probably going to do a lot of side quests and shit, but also, oh, we're going to fly, baby. I can't wait. See you guys then. Peace.